In this video, we'll start with the basics and review what alternative text is, where alternative text can go, the alt attribute, and why the alt attribute matters. Check out our other alternative text videos and the article version of this content below. Let's get started. Put simply, people who use assistive technology like screen readers use alternative text to get descriptions of images. For example, the alternative text for this image could be ocean at sunset. It's important the description serves the equivalent purpose as the image, which we talk about more in our Writing Great Alternative Text video. Let's go over where alternative text can go. It can either be on the webpage near the image or in the HTML alt attribute. Whether the alternative text is on the page or in the HTML alt attribute, every image should have an alt attribute, even if it's empty. If there is an empty alt attribute, the screen reader will skip the image. But if there is no alt attribute, the screen reader will announce the image and could say the image file name or something else depending on the screen reader and its settings. This is what Mac's VoiceOver screen reader says when it comes to an image with no alt attribute.
Welcome to VoiceOver. To get missing image descriptions, open the context menu. Unlabeled image.
This is what it sounds like when the image has an alt attribute.
Ocean at sunset image.
As we heard, the alt attribute is important because screen readers and other assistive technology read the alt attribute text out loud to convey the meaning or purpose of images. But it also shows in an image's place if images don't load for any user. And lastly, search engines use the alt attribute text to improve search results. Now that you know more about alternative text, you're ready to learn about the different types of images when it comes to alternative text and when your HTML alt attribute should be empty.